to Sherry Show. For today's episode, we're gonna cook for you chicken plum. Chicken plum is actually a very tasty dish, which everywhere around the world, they make it with their own recipes. Today, I'm gonna show you how to make a chicken plum with my own recipe. Are you ready? Let's cook together. We have some chicken thigh, black plums, yellow plums, onions, tomato paste, served with rice, and tomato and lemon juice. My spices are salt, cumin, black pepper, turmeric, paprika, and saffron. Saffron is optional. And then we have some melted butter or ghee, also some vegetable oil. So previously, this is my chicken thigh. I cut the bones out because we don't want the bones in it. And we cut the chicken in big pieces. We don't want small pieces in this stew, okay? And I washed the chicken, you guys. This is served for 4 people. The first thing you do, you put some olive oil in your pan. Not too much, just this much. I'm putting my onions in there to saute them a little bit. The reason I choose black plums and yellow plums, black plums is a little bit sweet and yellow plums is a little bit sour. So we want the dish to be sweet and sour. So we soak few black plums in the water. These are dry plums, you guys. You could buy it anywhere at any store. And then you use a little bit of yellow plums and we soak them. These plums that I bought from the store, they're seedless, there's no seed in them. The reason I'm soaking the plums in the water because I want them to look fresh, not dry, when I'm actually cooking it with my chicken. I showed you guys how to make rice. So previously I washed my rice, this is basmati rice. I wash my rice and soak it in the water for half an hour, 45 minutes is good. And I put some salt in it. And then later on, I'm gonna show you how to boil the water and then add your rice to cook your rice. But now I'm going to peel the tomatoes because I'm going to make tomato puree. Instead of using, you know, tomato cans, you know, puree in a cans, I like to make my own fresh puree, tomato puree. So I peel them just like this. There's so many ways to peel a tomato. You could also freeze it and then put it in a hot water to peel it, but this is the fastest way. If you don't have a mixer or like I have a magic bullet, if you don't have that, you could always grate, you know, your tomatoes. And because I'm serving for 4 people, so this 2 tomatoes is enough for making a puree. And then in there, I'm going to add 1 full teaspoon of tomato paste, just like that. This magic bullet is perfect for this kind of stuff, you guys. So, and then I'm going to make my tomato puree. Okay, that's good. Okay, at this time I'm adding, this is a half a teaspoon because this teaspoon is very small teaspoon. Half a teaspoon of turmeric, half a teaspoon of cumin, half a teaspoon of black pepper, half a teaspoon of paprika. I forgot to tell you we're adding cinnamon too. So I'm adding half a teaspoon of cinnamon in there too. So you guys, my mom, what she does, she always mix the spices for me. And I call it mom's mix of spice. She puts in there turmeric, cumin, black pepper, cinnamon, and some more stuff. which I'm gonna go to my mom's next time, and then she's gonna show us how to mix the spices like this. So you don't have to have all those spices. You could have just mix a spice like that and mix it yourself and use it all the time if you want to use all these spices together. Mmm, smells so good. Can smell all these spices. Now I'm going to add my chickens one by one in here. At this time I'm adding my salt, 1 full teaspoon of salt. So remember you guys on our previous show that I show you guys how to cook a rice. When we have 2 cups of rice, basmati rice or any kind of rice that you want to cook, you put 4 cups of boiling water. So I previously boiled my 4 cups of water. I drained the water from the rice that I soaked before, and I'm putting it in to my boiling water. And now I'm going to put my butter or ghee in there. Whenever you put butter or ghee in the rice, it will taste so good. Once you make sure that your chicken are actually fried very nicely, you take them out from the onions, because at this point you're going to make the sauce, and I'm going to show you how to make the sauce. So if you guys remember, I soaked my plum before, so I'm gonna add it here. And then I'm adding my other plums in there. And then we want it this big because it looks so nice in the dish after that. Okay. And then at this point, I put 1 tablespoon of tomato paste in there. And then I'm gonna put my tomato puree in there. Mmm, so good. I wish you guys could have smelled it. It smells so nice. I'm gonna add a little bit of, maybe 1/2 cup of boiling water in there. As I said before, saffron is optional, but I like to put saffron in there because it gives a very nice taste to the dish. And I showed you guys before how you actually cook the saffron. And this is 1/2 teaspoon of a saffron that I'm putting in here. Then I'm going to add a boiling water in there to bring the color of saffron out, and it will taste much better when it's actually cooked. When your sauce is boiling like this, it's ready for you to put your chickens in them and let it cook together. This is a sweet and sour dish, you guys, because of the plums. So we'll let it cook for 1/2 hour. So I squeeze lemon juice, fresh lemon juice in here, because I'm gonna put a little bit of lemon juice in there. It makes it taste sweet and sour with the plums and lemon juice. It will taste really nice. As you can see, then I'm adding 2 teaspoons of saffron water in there, and I will let it cook for another 15 minutes. So look at our rice, it's so fluffy and nice. At this point, I'm making a hole in the middle. Remember I told you, when you actually put a hole in the middle, the rice will cook much better. And then I'm adding saffron water here. Here you have it, you guys. Chicken plum served with basmati rice. I serve it with yogurt too. So let's try and see how it tastes. Look at this rice, so fluffy and beautiful. And I'm gonna put some chicken in there and some plums. Oh, look at these plums. Look so good. Mmm. And I like the sauce. I'm gonna put the sauce in there. A little bit. Mmm. Oh, the chicken is so tender and juicy. Look at the plums are so juicy and tender too. Mmm. Sweet and sour. It tastes fabulous, you guys. Mm. I hope you guys are going to make this dish. It's very easy to make, but it's very tasty. And please send a picture of your own dish and show it to me so I can share it with everyone else. But until next time, cheers. Thanks for watching, you guys. If you like this video and you want to see more, please subscribe the channel and leave a comment below. I love to read your comments.